Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create the look of graphics seen in vintage green phosphor monochrome CRT computer monitors. Open a high contrast black and white graphic, or you could use black text over a white background. Since most CRT screens have an aspect ratio of 4:3, let's crop our image to that shape. To do this, open your crop tool and open the crop preset list. Click ratio and type in 4 for the width and 3 for the height. Drag the crop's bounding box in or out, as well as the image itself, to size and center it inside the 4:3 shape. Then press enter or return, or click the check mark to accept it. Since I already did this earlier, I'll click cancel. To ensure your results will look similar to mine, open your Move tool and go to Image and Image Size. Make its resolution 72 pixels per inch. Make its width and or height within 100 pixels of mine. If you are changing its width or height, before you do, make sure the chain link icon is active. This will ensure it keeps its 4:3 aspect ratio. Then click OK or press Enter or Return. We'll invert it by pressing Ctrl or Command I. Go to Select and Color Range. Open the list next to Select and click Shadows. Keep its fuzziness 20% and the range 65. Click the lock icon to unlock the layer and press the delete key on your keyboard to delete the black background. Deselect it by pressing Ctrl or Command D. We'll add black behind it by first creating a new layer under it. To do this, Ctrl or Command click the new layer icon. Check your foreground and background colors. If they aren't black and white, press D on your keyboard or click this icon. If they're reversed, press X or click this icon. To fill our empty layer with the foreground color, press Alt or Option plus Delete. Next, we'll convert our white graphic or text into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively, as well as allow us to replace it with a different graphic or text without having to redo any of the effects. Make your graphic active and click the icon at the upper right. Click Convert to Smart Object. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it 120 pixels. Make a copy of it by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Double-click Gaussian Blur of the copy to open it and type in 30. Make a copy of the copy and double-click Gaussian Blur. Type in 4. Make one more copy and double-click an empty area of the layer to open its layer style window. Click Color Overlay. The blend mode is normal. Click the color box and in the hexadecimal field type in 4C 3 times. This gives us a 30% gray color. Then click OK on both windows or press Enter or Return twice. To save space in the Layers panel, let's collapse the smart filters. Click the Adjustment Layer icon and click Gradient Map. Click the gradient bar. When the gradient editor opens, if the gradient bar isn't black and white, open the Basics folder and click the black to white preset thumbnail. Click below the bar to add another stop, and for its location, type in 90. Click the color box, and in the hexadecimal field, type in 00BD09. Press Enter or Return twice to close both windows. Change its blend mode to Overlay. Make a new layer. We'll fill it with white. And since our background color is white, press Ctrl or Command plus Delete. Convert it into a smart object. Go to Filter, Sketch, and Halftone Pattern. The pattern type is line, the size is 2, and the contrast is 0. Change its blend mode to soft light. Make a copy of it and change its blend mode to normal. Reduce its opacity to 15%. Double-click an empty area of the layer to open its layer style window. Click Color Overlay and change the blend mode to darken. Click the color box and type in 06FF00. Then press Enter or Return twice. Let's collapse the smart filters. Control or Command click the thumbnail of the top graphic or text to select its shape. We'll add each of the three blurred shapes below it to our selection by pressing Control or Command plus Shift over each thumbnail. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection next to the active layer, which is the top scan lines. As I toggle the layer mask off and on, we can see how masking out the top scan lines improves the contrast of our graphic or text.
This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.